Hello everyone, I'm Riccardo Guidotti and I'm an assistant professor at University of Pisa and I'm also part of KDD Lab, a joint research group with ICCNR in Pisa. Today I'm very happy to present you our work explaining sentiment classification with synthetic exemplars and counterexemplars. This work is a joint work with Orestes Lampridis from Aristotle University of Thessaloniki and Salvatore Ruggeri from University of Pisa. So, what is sentiment classification and why it is important? Well, opinions nowadays are widely expressed in social media for the most different purposes. And sentiment classification is the task of learning a model which is able to predict the sentiment of a given test. The problem with sentiment classification, especially with respect to social media, is that the tests under analysis are generally very short, sparse, non-uniform, very different among each other, and full of noise. Thus, the best models, which are widely recognized to be good for assessing this task, are deep neural networks and random forest. However, such a model are also recognized to be black box models, that is, models which are not accessible, or even though we can access the internals, as humans we cannot understand and find out the reasons for the classification. This obscurity, this not transparency, can lead to some problems. For instance, one example is the gender bias. In an experiment using a deep neural network and a word-to-vec model, was asked a machine to complete some sentences like "man is to computer programmer as woman is to X," and AI says that X is homemaker. And this was because the training set used by the machine was an historical set of documents where women were mostly depicted as homemaker. And most of these examples were possible with this model. To prevent such cases, the European Union promulgated as law the GDPR, which, let's say, pushes towards a right of explanation, especially for companies producing tools and methods and softwares that realize and provide a decision for individuals. And this decision is automatic, then an explanation must be provided together with it. From an academic point of view, what we want to address is the black box outcome explanation problem. We are given a black box model B and an instance X classified by the system. What we want to provide is an explanation I for the decision Y returned by the black box. What we want to do is to tackle this problem by deriving a local neighborhood of the instance X, much more accurate than the state of the art. And we want to do it by using variational autoencoders for generating, encoding, and decoding local neighborhood, which are somehow realistic with respect to those of other methods in the state of the art, such as LIME, that work only by suppression. With respect to state of the art, we can find two big families, the model agnostic methods such as LIME and SHAP, that have two inconveniences. The first one is that they do not consider existing relationship between words, and the second is that they do not contain the neighborhood generated does not contain meaningful text. And the other family is done of model-specific approaches that can explain only specific type of deep neural networks. And so we want to aim for a model-agnostic approach that generates a proper neighborhood. That's why we exploit variational autoencoder that in summary takes as input a sentence and compresses it into a low dimensional representation called latent space by assuming a unit Gaussian distribution of this latent space. And then there is another part called decoder that from the low dimensional representation returns the original sentence or a good approximation of it. The Vanishing autoencoder enables us to design expels. The name stands for Explaining Sentiment Prediction Generating Exemplars in the Latent Space. Let's see how it works in the details. So at the beginning we have the black box B, the instance to explain X, and the classification 8 in this case. X is passed through the encoder and compressed into the latent space. Then a neighborhood generation function in assuming a Gaussian distribution is used to generate instances similar to Z. And finally, Z is decoded by eta, the function eta, obtaining real sentences like those depicted in the bottom. On these real sentences, we can apply the black box and obtain the sentiment classification Y that is used in the subsequent part. Now, let's stop for a second and analyze how expels is different from lime in terms of neighborhood. So, if the original sentence is the stupid brown fox, lime only works by suppression and so can generate sentences like stupid brown, stupid fox, brown fox, etc., etc. On the other hand, expels generate similar sentences, replacing words or working with synonyms, antonyms, and all the goodness of this generation is driven by how good is the variational autoencoder pre-trained before the explanation model. So sentences can be stupid red dogs, silly red fox, etc. In the second part, given the latent space Z and the classification Y, expels trains a local and latent decision tree classifier. And from this decision tree classifier is retrieved the final explanation. So starting from the path going from the root to the leaf of the classified instance depicted by the red point in this slide, we have the set of neighbors respecting the same latent rule of the instance classified. And these instances are called exemplars, that is, sentences which are similar to the one classified by the black box and obtaining the same label. While on the closest leaves working on the tree following the path, we can obtain the counterexemplars that are similar sentences obtaining a different classifications. So these exemplars and counterexemplars can help the user to understand why the given sentence is classified like this, because they highlights the discrepancy and what is discriminative for the black box to return positive sentiment rather than negative sentiment. In addition, we enhanced the explanation with the most frequent word, most common words extracted from the exemplars and counterexemplars. So let's see the experiments we have performed. We worked on two datasets, Height and Polarity. Both are tweets dataset, and we trained two black box classifiers on both datasets, the Random Forest from scikit-learn and a deep neural network from Keras. You can find the details in the paper. Here in the tables, you can see the accuracy of the models and the reconstruction of the variational autoencoder, which is trained on 75% of the remaining part of the test set from the original data. So before seeing the quantitative evaluation, let's look and have a look for a qualitative evaluation to understand which are the differences from a state-of-the-art method like LIME that is taken as baseline in this work and expels. So the sentence under analysis here is from the polarity data set and has a negative sentiment, as it says, while some of the camera work is interesting, the film's mid to low budget is betrayed by the surprisingly shoddy makeup work. However, Limes just returns a subset of words with the weights pushing the classification towards one or another direction. And in this case, it's counterintuitive that work has the highest weight, as is neither a positive or a negative sentence. On the other hand, expels returns exemplars and counterexemplars that helps to understand why things can be positive or negative. For instance, we have that a counterexemplar is that a film that plays things so nicely and safe, while an exemplars is an attempt to debut sense with the summer. Or in the end, I kept this one at 2 stars, understanding that these sentences are exemplars expressing a negative concept. And from this shortlisted exemplars and counterexemplars, it's possible to extract the words on which you can focus to have your eyes to see why the tweet is classified as positive or not. Besides the qualitative evaluation, we also performed a quantitative evaluation with respect to 3 measures. The first one is the fidelity, that is calculated as the accuracy with respect to the label returned by the black box. And the models evaluated are the local surrogate models of expels and Lyme, respectively. So on one hand, we have the decision tree. On the other hand, we have the Lasso linear regressor. And we can see that besides having a higher fidelity, expels is also much more stable with the lowest standard deviation. These are aggregate results on the test set. Then we tested the usefulness of exemplars and counterexemplars as explanation in a very simple simulation, but quite good for understanding their power. And since we cannot validate them with humans, we replaced the humans with a one nearest neighbor classifier trained with very few exemplars and counterexemplars. And these one nearest neighbors assigns to an unseen sentence the sentiment only based on exemplars and counterexemplars. So we measured the usefulness as the accuracy of the classification of this one nearest neighbor, and the baseline were the same classifier, but instead of being trained with exemplars and counterexemplars, it was trained with random sentences selected from the dataset. And so we see that also varying the number of exemplars and counterexemplars, the usefulness of the instances generated by expels is much more higher than those randomly selected. Finally, we evaluated the stability of this explanation for both Lyme and expels, as they are using randomic components in their explanation generation, and the idea is that similar tests should get similar explanation. We evaluated them using the local Lipschitz estimation, and we can see that results are not extraordinary, but stability of expels is comparable to the stability of Lyme for both dataset and black boxes. So, expels is a local model agnostic explainer using the latent feature space learned with a variational encoder for the neighborhood generation process that returns explanations consisting in exemplars, counterexemplars, and the most frequent words on this text. An extensive experimentation shows that expels addresses state-of-the-art deficiency and shows to be useful, stable, and faithful. As future research direction, we would like to use different type of encoders to return more realistic exemplars and counterexemplars. augment the explanation with logic rules built on top of them, and extend spells to words also on long text, maybe adopting a word-to-vec model and embedding as input-output for the variation of the encoder. In addition, we would like to empower expats by using external linguistic resources like a thesaurus or an ontology. And finally, we would like to conduct an experiment involving human performing a decision-making task driven by expert explanation for really assessing the goodness of the explanations returned by expats. And that's it. Thank you for your attention. Please feel free to email me any questions.